To wisdom era online classes. Now we shall study plants and animals for grade 3. Plants and animals. Plant animals move from one place to another place in search of food. On other hand, most of the plants are fixed to the ground where they cannot move from one place to another place in search of food because they prepare their own food. Animals eat plants or other animals for their existence. Animals cannot make their own food as because they depend on plants or any other animals for their food. Animals like cow and buffaloes eat grass. But some animals like lions, tigers, cat eat other animals. Lions, tigers, cat eat other animals. Because animals cannot prepare their own food. However, green plants make their own food with the help of water, air, and sunlight. We have already known what is the process by which plants prepare their own food. Yes, my dears, and even we should know some non-green plants like molds and mushrooms get their food from dead and rotting matter. We have studied that green plants can make their own food, but our surroundings consists of non-green plants. As they prepare, they cannot prepare their own food. Now we shall just see how green plants prepare their own food using sunlight, glucose, carbon dioxide, water, and using all these things, they prepare their own food. In this process, they still let oxygen out from their process, which is useful for the human. This process is called photosynthesis. Yes, my dears, animals breathe through lungs, gills, or air holes. As we are all having lungs, we breathe through our lungs. But some animals don't have lungs to breathe, where they breathe through gills or air holes. Animals like horses, tigers breathe through lungs, and even human beings are also breathing through their lungs only. Fishes have gills which help them to breathe inside the water. We all know that fishes are the aquatic animals where they live inside the water. Insects like ants, flies have air holes on their bodies which help them to breathe. We all have seen the ants, flies which have air holes, which might not be seen to us, but still they have their air holes which helps them to breathe. Even plants breathe through tiny pores which are present on the leaf, where these tiny pores are called as stomata. We shall study about stomata in our next class, that is in our grade 4. Now we shall just having a knowledge, plants breathe through tiny spores which are present on their leaves, Animals even have sense organs. The sense organs are like skin, eyes, nose, ears, and tongue. What are the sense organs which are present in the animals are like eyes, nose, skin, ears, and tongue. These organs help them to know about the world around them. Yes, my dears, just think, if you are not having eyes, you could not see your world around. Where it is a sense organ which helps all of us to look about the world around us. Even if we are not having nose or ears, we cannot smell the good odors. If we are not having ears, we cannot listen the good words. Is it not so that we would not be able to see our world around, which helps them to know about world around. Next, animals reproduce by laying eggs or giving birth to their young ones. Animals have a special characteristic. Not only animals, but all the living organisms have some special characteristic like reproduction, where reproduction is by two processes. Either it might be by laying eggs or giving birth to their young ones directly. Some animals like snakes and birds lay eggs. Babies hatch from these eggs. Yes, my dears, we are all have might be seen the eggs. Like hen eggs we have all seen. But there are some animals like snakes and birds lay eggs. Babies come out from those eggs. Some animals like cats and cows give birth to their young ones. Give birth to their young ones directly, where they do not lay any eggs, but they produce directly. That means they give birth to their young ones directly. Most of the plants produce seeds. These seeds give birth or give rise into a new plants. This is also a form of reproduction, but it is in the plants. Some new plants can grow from the plant part itself. We shall study all these things very briefly in our higher classes. But we should just know the information that some animals, some plants can grow with the help of part of the plant, like hibiscus or rose. If we are cutting the stem of that plant and growing it into a new plot, if we are growing it in a new pot, it will grow into a new plant. That is what if it is reproducing by other plants of the plant. Now, animals and plants depend on each other. Animals and plants depend on each other. Why do they depend on each other is to live. Plants and animals depend on each other to live. If there are just enough plants, just enough plant eating animals and just enough flesh eating animals in the world, there is a balance in nature. There is a balance in nature. If you are eating, or if someone is eating only rice, is that possible? No, you should eat some other vegetables or some other things to live. And even it is having help from other animals also. When there are too few animals of kind such as tiger, this balance get disturbed. When there are many kinds of many same kinds, this balance get disturbed. When we cut down too many trees without planting new ones, this also get disturbed in balance. When if we are not at all growing a new trees, how human beings can breathe where oxygen is given out from the plant?
My dears, we have learned so many.